James on a Tuesday. Isn't this such a beautiful song? It's overcast outside. I love listening to a little jazz. Today's payday. It's amazing. Somebody goes, oh.
What's up, party people? I think that was Jared. What's up, Jared?
Texas in the house. Whoa.
So.
Aren't y'all feeling super blessed today? I am. Always wake up with a grateful heart.
Every day we wake up. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
And we'll sit in bed and it's just like, we gotta pinch ourselves. We don't have to go to work. I mean, we work on the business, but we don't have to go to a job. And it's just such, it's a blessing. It's a blessing. And we want all of you right here with us. So
thank you for joining us. We are charging along in our 90-day game plan. But before we get into it, my name is Paul.
And I am Lynette. And yes, I love this guy. He brightens my day. So thank you for being with us. We, again, are having hundreds of people following us on Periscope. It is the epitome of network marketing because we don't advertise. And it's a beautiful thing. So welcome. If you've never been on Periscope, we just want to let you know that we are holistic health coaches, but we're also industry trainers. We train on new business 2.0 methods. Out with the old. Let's kind of bring in some new stuff because businesses are shifting. And whether you own a traditional business, a franchise, or network marketing business, you can absolutely take away these tips and have some really amazing things happen in your life. And as always, we want nothing more to add value to your life. But today's episode is kind of special. We're going to go over a lot of information, so if you think this is monotonous, that's okay, because I actually had a conversation with Paul this morning, and I said to myself, I got to get off this crazy train.
Crazy train.
So again, we want to remind you to have self-assessment checks all day long so you can get yourself off that crazy train, because if you can manage it, that's when your business will shift. So my crazy train thought this morning was, we're kind of going over the same thing, and it sounds monotonous, it sounds boring and unsexy, but with that said, I do know that we have many followers that have been following us with many episodes, because we're on episode 72 episodes, and many of you have been with us from the very beginning, but we also have brand new people. So I want to make sure that's our job as industry trainers and leaders to make sure that the new guys that are just jumping on board, again, you don't have to speak clearly, obviously, to build this business. But I want to make sure that the new guys who are just now jumping on board understand the significance of the two-week turnaround and the rule of five. But today we're going to go over some special stuff. We're going to do a little bit of house cleaning because I am still seeing some things that can totally shift your business if we can kind of clean up some of this fuzzy stuff.
So real quick, when we're talking about the stuff that we talk about, you know, we said early on, that if we sound like a broken record, good. Because that's the only record you should be listening to. Because there's not much to the business, and we've layered a lot of information, but now we just give it all to you all the time. I mean, it's just like, it is what it is, and here you go. So,
and that's the beautiful thing about one of the most important things. If you can write anything down from today's episode, it is to be the biggest giver. Jill Bowman has taught us this, and it really has shifted my business because I was not a giver in the very beginning. And what I mean by being a giver does not mean monetary. What I mean by giving is giving your heart, giving your love, giving your compassion, giving a little bit of kudos to people, being a professional cheerleader or an encourager, just adding value to people's lives. And many of you are still not doing that, and that is why your business has stalled or has plateaued. You're still not giving enough value. And if you're sitting behind Periscope wondering why Paul and I are succeeding or why other leaders are succeeding faster than you, it's just because we've mastered how to add value to people's lives better than you.
Consistently.
And that's it. It's not something that can't be learned. You can learn it, and we're teaching you how to do that. And be mindful each time that you get on Facebook, each time that you're out and about, to never stop adding value to people's lives. And what do I mean by that? And I'm going to give you a quick example so we can then recap. But many of you have been messaging me, and I can tell where you're at in your self-development, because I don't even know some of you, and the first thing you do is just ask me a question. I don't even know who you are, and you just ask a question. And I want to emphasize how lazy in leadership this is. It is very important that, in case you don't know anybody or you want to get to know somebody, to just say their name. The power of saying someone's name is like music to their ears.
Guys, this is from Dale Carnegie. I mean, this is like, this has been around for a long time. People know about these principles.
And you can easily just say, "Hi, Lynette," compliment, and then ask a question. "Hi, Lynette. You've given me so much value on these Periscope trainings, and I just wanted to say thank you for that. May I ask a question?" And then you can ask your question. Rather than just going straight into the question, I'm more apt to answer you. I'm more apt to engage with you. And some of you, I really want to emphasize before, because I know you want to jump in, but because you don't even know how to talk to me and communicate with me, I can only imagine how you're talking to your team and your prospects. So it's a little bit of tough love, and Reds, we got to work on this, because I was there. I would just go straight into asking my question. I mean, I don't even speak to Jill that way. She is my enrolling sponsor. She's our 13-star platinum. It is always, "Good morning, beautiful." And then I would ask a question. And she does the same thing for me. It's a mutual respect. So I really want to emphasize, don't be lazy in your leadership, and please do not be lazy in your communication. This is where you can make a massive shift in your business and with your own team by just learning how to communicate and adding value to people's lives. Okay, I'll just say that.
Yeah, guys, it's not because we need a compliment.
No.
It's actually because you should be in practice in communicating correctly with everyone that you talk to. I don't care if you've known them for your whole life or you just met them. It should be the same thing, because you should be able to, you know, pass on the philosophy, or the framework of respect and, you know, a high quality communication style that will only benefit you in every area of your life. Because we've talked about this before, the quality of your life, and in particular the quality of your business, because that's what we're here talking about, is based largely upon the quality of your communication. I would say if you don't get anything else out of all 90 Periscopes that we're going to do, and the 71 that we've done before up to this point, if you don't get anything out of it, if you just got this one thing, then you could totally change your entire life in whatever direction that you want, to improve the quality of your communication on a daily basis, even just a little bit.
I mean, you always want to leave someone in a better state than before they met you. And how amazing is it that we're giving value to your life, but in return to message Paul and I and just pour love into us and say how grateful for you, you know, you are for us. We're giving value and adding value back to our life. It's full circle. So please watch your communication. This is just the most beautiful book that I'm on a 30 books in 30 days. This has actually been one of my favorite books. It's The Starbucks Experience. And it really talks about taking customer service to a whole nother level. And it's a beautiful thing, especially when you're in a product page, when you can...
What does it really talk about? Yeah. It talks about improving the quality of your communication.
It really does.
I mean, that's beautiful. What it's about.
Great, great, powerful book.
Most of these books, the self-improvement books, success-driven books, their primary message is to, in some way, improve the quality of your communication. I mean, look at How to Win Friends and Influence People. You know, one of the principles, for lack of a better term, or whatever, you know, whatever he wants to call it, is stop criticizing, condemning, or complaining.
Oh, we're going to go into this.
Why?
We got to go into some housekeeping, and I want to just really quickly go into this before we go into our training. But make some mental notes and listen to what Paul and I are saying, because I struggled with this in the beginning. It was really, really hard for both Paul and I. Paul was much better than I was, because my red was raging red. And I didn't know how to communicate. I didn't know how to encourage, because my ego was so big. And I'm still rough around my edges, but I've learned a whole lot along the way, because I learned that it's not about me. It's about your team. It is about your prospects. It's about your customers. And I mean, I didn't mean to interrupt you. Do you want to finish your thought?
No, I mean, it's a common thread in any book that you read. Improve the quality of your communication, you'll improve the quality of your life.
So Paul and I want to reemphasize, because these are things that we learned from Jack Canfield when we went to our Amplified Leadership training in Vegas, which was just in June. If you were there, it was mind-blowing. It was actually Jack Canfield and actually John Maxwell. And it is this: leaders must exceed expectations. And this includes with communication. So although I don't write a whole big book when I communicate with people or verbal vomiting like I used to, but I will continue to exceed people's expectations. And if you can watch Paul and I in our own product page, if you have the opportunity to watch us, I always exceed expectations. If someone asks a question, I always give a nice answer. It's not super detailed. Sometimes it is. Most of the time I learn to condense it, but it's still a nice added value answer. And then I attach a tool. I attach an article.
Guys, this is principle number 24 in the Success Principles. That's Jack Canfield's book. I mean, there are books written on this particular subject, okay. And that's just one chapter, but...
But everything is, you always want to exceed people's expectations. People have been messaging me, just random strangers off of Periscope training, because you somehow found us. I forgot where I was going with that. I had a thought, sorry.
Exceeding expectations.
Yeah. I'll come back to it.
Okay.
But yes, leaders always exceed expectations. We are never lazy in our language. Leaders are strategizing. Again, Paul and I always teach, you know, these new 2.0 methods. No more throwing mud up against the wall when you're on Facebook. Every single move, every single post, and every single comment is strategized. So please be aware of everything that you are putting on Facebook. That's why Paul and I don't get into political stuff. We don't get into religious stuff, anything controversial, nothing like that. Keep everything nice, neutral, and positive on your Facebook profile page. You are branding yourself, right?
And I know what a lot of the Reds are saying. That's just me. But that's just me. I just want to say what I feel. Listen, you can be rich or you can be right, but you can't always be both. So, you know, chill out with your political rants and the things that you think that everybody should know about how you feel about this particular topic. You're branding yourself. You are trying to create an idea of somebody that thinks in a certain way, somebody that acts in a certain way, and somebody that behaves in a certain way, so that you can create curiosity, not lying to people, not creating an image that's not real, but putting out the stuff on your Facebook page that matters to you and your business, okay? The fact that you have a political leaning one way or the other, it does not matter. It doesn't matter. That's just your own personal beliefs and your own personal opinions. But if you're trying to build a business, a 6- and 7-figure-a-year business, you want to open the market up as much as possible, and trying to pigeonhole yourself into one particular belief or way of thinking is not doing that. Guys, you're only hurting yourself. So these kind of things are important, because never... I didn't have Facebook before we started.
He was so anti-social media.
Yeah, I actually really didn't like it. But Lynette said, well, we can make 6 figures a year. And I'm like, okay, I'm over it. So I opened my account, and never, you can look through my entire history, have I put in a negative comment. Never have I put a political rant. Never have I put an attack on anybody or something controversial.
And even more importantly, Paul doesn't, I mean, despite how big he is, how muscular he is, Paul has never put a muscular selfie on his Facebook page. How egotistical can that be after seeing selfie, after mirror shot, after muscular shot, after ab shot,
guys,
after muscle shot? It's like, okay, I get it. It's all about me.
Well,
he has such a servant's heart, and it's always about others. So I want to really clear that up.
And that's the whole message. Guys, it's not about what you believe or what you think. It's about what other people can benefit from your solutions that you can provide.
No. He's not saying, I think a strong spiritual faith is commendable. That's fine. We're talking about controversial, negative things.
That's
what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Anything that's positive and uplifting, absolutely, absolutely do that. It's part of who you are, right? Yeah. So I think that's a beautiful thing, actually.
Yeah.
We also want to talk about never saying anything negative as a leader, and I really want to emphasize this, especially if you're in your product page. If you're a leader and you're building your business, you really want to be extremely careful with your words inside the product page. And that includes no negativity about a product, no negativity about customer service, no negativity about the industry, about the company, about other leaders and other team members. And I really want to emphasize this part because this is super important. Did you know that our thoughts and our energy are extremely, extremely powerful? And when you start talking negatively or you're frustrated about a team member, that you actually block their abundance. And if they're especially on your team, well, you're only blocking your own. Energies is very powerful, especially negative thoughts towards somebody else. I can't believe that person doesn't want to build their business. Why can't they just move? Why can't they just go? I don't understand. They're so lazy. All these negative things towards somebody else blocks their abundance and then blocks your own. So please don't do that. Just keep everything nice and neutral. Negativity doesn't even come out of Paul and I's mouth. And if we do, we're in a state of funk, we give ourselves 5 minutes and then we're off that funk immediately because we understand that the law of attraction works very powerful, especially when you're in alignment. So thoughts are things. Yes, thank you for that. So
real quick, I just want to clarify. I know we talk about there's some things you shouldn't do on Facebook. And I know somebody said I was just trying to inspire with my workouts and stuff. Guys, it's very different if the energy behind your posts are very different if you're trying to inspire people. There are certain, we've all seen it, certain people like to post on their Facebook page 10 times a day their ab shots.
Talking about,
man, I've worked hard, look at my abs, blah, blah, blah. Nobody cares about your abs, dude. In fact, they only care about their abs. So why are you showing yours? So the bottom line is, if you do that 10 times a day, guess what it does? It makes people move on. They don't want to see it anymore. They just scroll on. It doesn't do anything. So doing that once in a while, I get it. Okay, that's fine. But doing that as your main source of trying to get people interested, it doesn't work. It doesn't work because people don't connect with someone who says, man, I've been working hard, look at me. Okay, once in a while, when somebody does that, they'll look at that and they'll be like, well, if they relate that post in a way that I can connect with it, that I could have the same result, then that would make sense. But if that post is up there talking about, I have abs, I'm so awesome,
with 20 hashtags it's like, okay, it's enough. So please get off Instagram.
I've been in the health and fitness industry for 20 years. Nobody cares about, this is going to be tough for some of you.
I think they can handle it. They're ready. Drop some truth bombs. Don't you want to hear this?
Guys, nobody cares about your abs. Nobody cares about how amazing you look on a daily basis. I just can't stress that point enough. Guys, they only care about themselves. I hope that makes sense.
I mean, you're getting really passionate, but I just want to clarify. If you're putting a selfie or a transformation picture, it has a different intention when you're trying to inspire someone. But when you're self-absorbed, showing ab shot after ab shot with 20 hashtags behind it, you are not authentically connecting with somebody to help somebody and add value to their life. There is a big difference. So don't misunderstand what we're saying. Yeah. I think selfies and body transformations are amazing when you're on a beautiful journey.
Yes.
When you're on a beautiful journey. But I'm beating this. So I think I'm spending way too much time, but I think you understand what I'm talking about. Athletes are really bad with this. It's ab shot, mirror shot, mirror shot, mirror shot. It's like, okay, we get it. We get it. You have muscles.
And guys, guys, you might have 3,000 likes on that particular photo, but you don't make any money. Don't you understand that it's not working? Okay.
So 3,000 likes versus, you're not building a business. We need to do some self-assessment checks. But that's it. Let's talk about something else.
All right. We'll talk about something else.
Okay. So that was some housekeeping. Please be aware of the things that you say in the product page. No negativity, especially about the company, especially about a product. If you don't like the way something tastes, then don't say anything at all. Okay. if you have a customer or a prospect or somebody that's in your product page and they say that I don't like Isis snacks, then you should help negate it by saying, oh my gosh, the ice snacks taste like astronaut candy. I think they're amazing. Well, actually, I do think they taste like astronaut candy. So I'm being truthful. But just negate any negativity with something positive, okay, in your product page.
There you go. So. Don't yuck someone's yum. You don't know what else.
Oh, there you go. I like that.
You don't know what else someone will like.
I'm stealing that, Jackie.
So that's a great, great phrase.
Okay. Let's talk about the 10% formula really quickly. We're just doing some housekeeping, and then we'll go into the training. The 10% formula, since most of us, if you're in our company, We get paid today. In our company, we get paid daily, weekly, quarterly. We also get paid today because we get the quarterly holiday bonus. And we get paid yearly. Did I miss something?
Monthly.
Oh, yeah. Daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly. With that said, we are trying to move your mindset from an employee mindset over to the entrepreneur mindset. Because remember, today is not a paycheck. Today is revenue. So we must reinvest back into ourselves and pay ourselves first. Please don't get your nails done and go pay your bills and get your hair done and go shopping, right? Pay yourself first. And you're going to have separate funds or separate accounts so you can divvy up your revenue accordingly. Please reinvest back into your team. Don't spend thousands of dollars on leads and advertising. Reinvest back into your team. It's so much more profitable, and that's how you build a profitable business. So you're going to have, in our case, Paul and I have 2 checking accounts and 4 savings accounts. Why so many accounts? Well, we're not the most organized people. This keeps us organized. 2 checking accounts. One is for where we move money over from our ISA wallet straight into a checking account. And then we know how much our bills are each month, so then we'll divvy up and put all the bills into our checking account. The 4 savings account include business investments, personal development, taxes, and a savings account or a freedom account. Let me go over that again. 2 checking accounts and 4 savings accounts. I bank with Bank of America, so it's really nice and easy for me to shift and transfer money over on my Bank of America app. 2 checking accounts. Once I get paid on my ISA wallet, I get loaded, then I move everything over to my checking account, and then I move everything that's just for bills and rent and car payment and all that kind of stuff over to my other checking account. Then I have 4 savings accounts. 10% should go to business investments. This is where you're going to be reinvesting back into your business, back into your team. 10% should go to personal development, and that includes events. We have NYKO, which is one of our flagship events, in Dallas, Texas in January. You should be saving money now, so no excuses of why you can't attend an event, right, for hotels. And if you want to spend money on webinars, those kinds of things, that's personal development. You should have 10% go towards savings or a freedom fund, and then set aside money for taxes. It's not really 10% because it just depends on what bracket. We are not financial advisors, but that's just an awesome way for you to move your revenue into the appropriate accounts so you can start paying yourself first. Good. And I'm going to quickly go over power reading.
Oh, yeah. Something that we like to do because we love downloading new information in our brains as fast as possible.
Well, we go over the 2-week turnaround, and this is where everybody's really kind of messing up and dropping the ball, is reading. That is part of the 2-week turnaround. It is reading daily. And some of you have a real hard time reading, and that was me. I didn't like reading, or I would start a book and get to like through the first chapter, and then I would never read the rest of the book. But Paul taught me how to photo read or power read, and it's taking it to a whole other level. I actually enjoy reading now because I can get through a book like in 20 minutes. It is the most fascinating way to get through a book, and especially since we're in this 90-day game plan.
It's awesome.
It's like mind-blowing. So
real quick, we call it power reading because there's many different speed reading techniques, but the one that we primarily use is photo reading. Okay, photo reading is very simple, and it just is a simple way to not only review a book, going over some basic information, the front cover, the back cover, the table of contents, the index, right, and flipping through the pages fairly quickly so that you look at the bolded stuff, the chapter titles, the subtitles, things like that. So that'd be kind of previewing the book. And then when you're going through the book, there's a couple things that people misunderstand about books. When you can get this in your head, you'll actually get a lot more.
I'll go over the 2-week turnaround.
You'll get a lot more out of books. So books aren't, the goal is not to read a book from cover to cover.
The traditional, conventional way of reading a book, this is not what we're talking about.
That's how it was in school, but we're not in school anymore. We're in real life. So reading cover to cover book, every single word doesn't make sense. In fact, it's pointless because 90% of the words are the and it. You know, these kind of things are worthless words that don't mean anything to us anyway. There's only usually 1 to 2 key things that you can pull from a book at a time anyway. And what I mean at a time, I mean, the first time you read a book, you'll get something or a couple things out of that book. The second time you read a book, maybe 3 months later, you'll get a whole nother set of things because you've changed, because you're in a different space. But I've looked it up and I'm struggling.
Yes, I do understand that. I relate to you because I was in medical school and I've been taught to read word for word very slowly and highlight. So this is a new way to read, but if you practice, literally by the second time I read a book, doing power reading or photo reading, I was hooked.
So
it takes a little bit of a transition, and you can do it a little bit slower, but then you'll start speeding it up, and it's so much fun.
Guys, I would challenge you to at least photo read.
Yeah, Trina's doing it too.
Oh, cool. Yeah. So to photo read a book a week if you have never done it, and then you can go back to reading your daily routine. But honestly, the more you practice it, the better you'll get and the faster you'll get. So it's super simple. You can get through a book if you're new in about 20 minutes, an average size book, 300 to 400 pages. If you're a little bit more experienced, it takes about 10 minutes to get through a book and you're good.
But you want to do a physical book? Paul can do it on, what's it called?
I could do it on like digital. I use Scribd a lot.
But yeah. I'm kind of slower at this, so since I'm still kind of learning it, I prefer the physical book, not an auditory book. You need an actual physical book.
The beautiful thing is the retention is much higher than you think, number one. Number two, you actually start to come up with ideas, right?
Oh, Fuzzy just finished the photo reading book.
Oh, awesome. So yeah, you start to come up with ideas that you think that they're your own, and then you realize that actually, you know, you read this in a book a week ago, and it's coming out of your brain.
It's like literally it's downloading into your subconscious.
Yeah.
So do a Google search or a YouTube search on photo reading, photo reading, power reading, or even speed reading. There's different kinds of ways that you can do this. But for me, I mean, I do it a little bit different than Paul, but I'll take a book, like for instance, The Starbucks Experience, and I'll read the front cover, the inside flap, the back cover, I'll read the back flap, and I'll take my time on the table of contents because I need to pull out main principles of this book. So I'll take my time and read the contents, and then literally your speed reading, and what I mean by speed reading, you'll be really surprised how powerful the brain is and how powerful the subconscious mind is. So you're literally taking just a few seconds and going over each page, checking out the highlighted bold, and I'm just looking, you're thinking, I'm not getting anything out of this is not working. But trust us, it is. You'll be freaking surprised,
yeah.
Right? So I'm doing this. If something catches my eye, I will stop for a moment and do conventional reading. I'll read maybe the first line of each paragraph just so I can get the main idea. That's all I'm doing, is wanting to get and pull main ideas from this book. And I only have less than 10. That's all that I want. But what I want to stress is that how awesome it is if I can pull at least 10 main ideas or principles out of this book than struggling with trying to read it and not getting anything at all. So
let me clarify real quick. Why would you do this? If you can go through a book a day or even a book a week and you get 3 to 4 topics out of one book, but you did that in a week, let's say it's three main key points that you can apply to your life right away. You got 3 key points in 1 week as opposed to getting 3 key points in 1 month.
Ooh,
right? So even if you did 4 books a month, right, you've already got 12 key points as opposed to 3. So you're that much further ahead. The whole point of a book is to steal the information and apply it to your life and become a better person. Improve the quality of your communication.
I had a stack of books and now I'm like getting through all of them because all I want is just to get some key tips out of this. And then Paul taught me how to do mind mapping. Well, that's fun because I get to use pretty colors. because this is just so fascinating to me.
Mind mapping is just a technique in which to organize information on paper that relates to your brain. And I do have a few books on mind mapping, which is pretty cool stuff if you want to use it for school and studying and different things. But it works amazing for downloading information when you're photo reading.
Because I don't know if you can see this on Periscope, but when I used to take notes when I was in school, it was very linear, very just writing it out. But with mind mapping, because the way our brain stores information, I actually write like this now when I'm writing my notes. So no. the title of the book is here, and then I'm writing my key points out here, and I've got pretty colors, and then I just draw a line straight back to the title of the book. And it's much more fun because you can remember so much easier than writing in bullet point like you used to do in school, the boring way.
Guys, this, so much more fun. This chaotic mess here, what is perceived to be chaotic mess, is how your brain puts stuff together. This is more accurate to the brain than some linear line-by-line thing.
So, just a key tip, if you're struggling with reading, try power reading, try photo reading, do a little bit of mind mapping, and I guess there really is no wrong way to do it. There's probably more effective ways, but this works for me for now. So.
Yeah, and the whole point of this is not because, so you can say that you read a book a day. The whole point is to get a piece of information out that day from that book and apply it to your life, become better. And use it for your business. I mean, those that read the most will eventually have the best life. I mean, that's the bottom line. Yeah. Leaders are always readers, okay? We know this to be true. Warren Buffett, you know, he's famous for saying he reads 8 hours a day.
I ain't got time for that.
Bill Gates, he is legendary for reading 3 to 4 hours a day. Guys, this is just known facts that the richest people in the world tend to read hours and hours a day. Now, I don't know if they're photo reading or anything, but it doesn't matter. The fact is that they're reading. Leaders are always readers. Readers are not always leaders, but leaders are always readers, okay? So get that in the habit. We're going to jump in real quick now and move on
to training. Yeah. So just remember, if it makes you uncomfortable to power read or photo read, that's okay. Just try it, and then you can always go back and read that book the conventional way when you've got more time. But for right now, we're in a 90-day game plan. Just feed your mind with as much knowledge as you can and get through the 20 minutes. Just get it done. Because Paul and I always teach in the 2-week turnaround that reading daily is vital to your success. And you want to download as much information as you can. So let's go into our training because I know that we've got a lot of new people on. We got to go into the 2-week turnaround and the rule of five. We're going to clean up some stuff and we'll point some stuff out to make sure that you're not missing these vital steps because Paul and I are teaching new 2.0 methods, so the two-week turnaround and the rule of five is non-negotiable if you want to build a successful business using Facebook, not Instagram.
Okay, so we're going to give you a ton of information in a fairly short amount of time, so just bear with us and I'm sure you guys have questions, so we'll be happy to answer them over the week.
And if you've got this down and you're applying this, then you can jump off unless you want to stay on so you can learn to teach this to your team because you are, those that are watching on Periscope, you're either in the learning phase, you're learning from Paul and I and trying to absorb as much information as you can, or you've heard this before, but now you need to clean it up and learn how to teach it. So you're listening and watching through different eyes and different ears.
Yeah.
So it's really important.
So we always talk about you're either learning or you're leading, right?
So I want to start off with this, because I don't know if you guys know how powerful video is. In today's world, 2015, we're using Facebook, we're using our product page or our product group page. Videos are so important. And Paul and I teach about using video chat. If you're in a three-way chat, private message, that is so powerful too. You can send video chats via text also. But one of the things that I've learned from Tanya Kirkpatrick and Jill is they love using video inside their product page, how to teach people about the product. Because sometimes this is so amazing, and I really want to stress how important that is. Because I'm like linked arms with Jill, and she is so influential. And when she made this video today, it was actually really brilliant because all she did was make a video using our vitamins, and it was a video. She pulled this out to show the AM and PM pack. She turned it over, and in the video, she read this little saying here, and then she even opened this up to show that there is nutritional supplemental facts inside, and she just reiterated how amazing these vitamins are, and I swear to God, I went straight to my kitchen and I took it. I did, because I was like, I forgot to take my vitamins today, but I want to stress how amazing videos and how powerful videos are. So if you're really comfortable with using your cell phone, take a quick 1 minute or 2 minute video on how to make a shake, or if you're using the brand new organic coffee and how you make your coffee, because I use a French press, and Cass and Kyle Caldwell actually.
Cass, oh, you made us love get Cass. A French press.
She's the one that taught me about the French press and how powerful was it when she made that video. As soon as the new coffee came out, she made a video on how she made her coffee in the morning using a French press, and I think it's called a percolator or something that you boil water in. Mm. Everything was made out of glass instead of using a plastic coffee maker. And it really inspired me to go to Target and go buy a French coffee press and then start making my coffee. So I really want to emphasize, if you want to take your business to another level, use videos and show people how and teach people how to use the products. Mm-hmm. Very powerful.
So unfortunately for Cass, she didn't get any commission on our the French press Mr. Coffee thing that we bought. But the point is that you know, videos work.
And as always, Paul and I love teaching on Periscope because we know that people learn auditory, visual, and kinesthetically. So I've got my handy dandy whiteboard. If you don't know who I am, this is my thing. I love teaching and using my whiteboard because I'm visual. I've got to see. I've got to hear.
Okay, real quick clarification. So the videos that we're talking about, those would be teaching about the products. Those would be done in the product page, the group page, not on your personal page because there's no context for people to understand what that's about. Okay, so that's only in the product page.
Well, that would almost actually make sense. So maybe that's a new person that asked.
Yeah, I just clarified. Yeah.
Okay. So if you can see this, but Paul and I always teach about the two-week turnaround. Again, we're in the 90-day game plan. So all of this is going to be 10X'd. I don't know if Ashley Miller is watching right now, but your book is coming, The 10X Rule by Grant Cardone. We went to, I don't know, several bookstores, and that book was sold out.
Something's happening, guys. It's...
That book was sold out, so I had to order it on Amazon, so they're going to send it to you. I think you're going to get it on Friday, so hang with us, Ashley. The book is coming. I didn't forget about you. But Paul and I, you know, we're teaching, we're in the 90-day game plan. Everything is amplified over the next 90 days. Paul and I teach you about the two-week turnaround, and we also teach about the rule of five. What is this? Why do I have to do it? And is this valuable to me? None of this stuff we're making up. It is just amazing information that we've learned through our company, through, you know, isogenicsbusiness.com, through Jill Bowman, Tracy O'Malley, and Tanya Kirkpatrick, and all the amazing leaders. We're just presenting it to you in a nice, simplified, packaged way, and Paul and I give it to you so it's much more organized in little baby steps, if you will.
And somebody sent a message the other day talking about how we serve it in a bite-size, the serving. So thank you for noticing that, and hopefully that everyone can grab onto this. So
and this is super helpful because many of you get on Facebook and you have no idea really what you're doing, or you think you know what you're doing, but there is a strategic way to use Facebook. Again, get off Instagram. Instagram is not made for this because you can't, what Paul calls, you can't herd in the cats with Instagram. With Facebook, you can herd in the cats. Is that what you call it?
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough to create a dialogue. It's tough to really create a team community dialogue on Instagram, whereas Facebook is much more conducive with that. It's much more natural to do it that way on Facebook because of the ability to connect with people. They have the Facebook chat. They have video chat in that. They have the commenting, they have the posting, they have sharing, they have all these different things that you can dialogue with somebody with, whereas Instagram is much less friendly in that regard. So,
okay, so if your business has stalled out or your team has stalled out, you always want to start off with a two-week turnaround because this will shift your business over the next 2 weeks, but you've got to do this every single day, every single day. And then you start amplifying and move into the rule of five, and this should be done also every single day. But this will keep you organized, and it goes straight into the 90-day game plan. If you have your handy-dandy book, if you go over to page 63, right, you can make sure that you're hitting these bullet points doing this stuff on a daily basis, and your business will shift.
A lot of the two-week turnaround kind of kickstarts your opportunity to apply the rule of five. Okay, so why do we have two sets of five things? Right. This is to get your brain ready and your mindset shifting and to create an opportunity to start applying this. Okay?
Okay, because you can do all the technique that you want, but if your energy isn't, because Paul and I teach energy first, technique second. If you haven't mastered this or you're forgetting any of this stuff, this technique stuff down here is not going to work as effectively. So please make sure that you're doing this stuff up here. Mm-hmm. And number one, we always want to say this because this is the most important, and that's add value to people's lives every single day without fail. You never stop adding value. And I love how people are using Buffer and Hootsuite to post.
So real quick, there's the two-week turnaround first, and then the rule of five, not necessarily. it kind of all meshes together in a very seamless way. But if you have a certain hang up, or if you're feeling stuck, or if you're brand new, you don't know what to do, this is the place to start. Okay?
So adding value, this is what we talk about, complimenting, and then ask a question. When you're out and about at Target, or you're having dinner with someone, or you meet somebody in yoga class or at the gym, you always want to compliment and ask a question. That opens up a more authentic way to communicate, and more people are apt to connect with you. So please never stop adding value to people's lives. And you'll be adding value both outside of Facebook, and you'll be adding a whole lot while you're building your business on Facebook. Mm-hmm. Never stop adding value. It's not about you, it's about them. Paul and I talked about power reading and how you can start implementing reading every single day now with power reading. Paul and I literally read a book a day. It's not just about the physical aspect of reading and getting information from the book, but it's literally absorbing the energy of the author, of the success-driven book. You're absorbing the author's energy, and that's why we talk about reading is so, so important.
Me and 50.
You're reading 50 Cent?
We're practically hanging out together, me and 50. So I'm absorbing all the energy from the author.
Oh, my God.
But no, that's actually an incredible book. But the whole point is it's like magic. I mean, there's these people I've never met. Some these people are not around. Some of them passed on, right? But the whole point is we can still feed off of their energy. The energy is in the book. It's in the words and the wisdom that they've come up with and that they interpret into text for us. So.
Annie Medina, do you see what I have to go through? Annie is laughing at us. please make sure that you're branding yourself. And if you're a leader, please make sure that your team is branding themselves. I love to do this. I love watching my team brand themselves, take a screenshot of their post, whether it's in the product page or whether it's on their personal page. I'll take a screenshot of my team's post, and I'll put it in my business page and give them a shout out, because I want to encourage them to keep going. I want to encourage them that I'm watching them and I like what they're doing. So I need them to keep going. So that's a great tip. If you're a leader and you've got a team, take a screenshot of your team members
doing it right.
Yeah. And then post it in the business page and say, good job. I'm so glad that you're doing it the
correct way. Because other people want to know what you're doing, and they can literally steal the idea and post it on their page.
And especially if you have brand new team members, they can go, oh, that's how they're posting. Oh, that's how they do it.
Yeah.
So you're also teaching the brand new team members when you uplift your other members.
So real quick, there are five habits here that we're trying to create, but under the branding there is five as well. So somebody asked, do you have any recommendations on how to brand myself? Yes, we have it all broken down for you, and we're going to go into that right now. So the branding yourself is very specific. Now this does not stop you from posting about your cat and about all the cool drawings that your kids put out there, because that's important, it's part of your life. But the five things that you do want to also include in your posting efforts for the day.
This is every day you're going to be branding yourself.
Guys, this is now every single day.
Now, I want to just reemphasize, because some of you may have not already heard this. When we tell you to brand yourself five times a day, don't get freaked out by that. Because the way the new Facebook algorithm works, most of your posts will not even be seen. But this is just a way for you to start shifting the energy and shifting your business over the next 2 weeks. So this is part of it. You've got to brand yourself five times a day. And if you're overwhelmed with that, then please use Buffer or Hootsuite, which is an automated way to post. But you have to be branding yourself or rebranding yourself five times a day. And this is minimum. We're kicking it up a notch. We're 10Xing everything, right? We're 10Xing everything in the 90-day game plan. So we're going to get uncomfortable, okay? 10Xing everything.
Okay, so the five posts that you're going to put out there for your business every day, minimum, like she said, we're 10Xing everything. The first one is like a health quote. The second one is a wealth quote. The third one is a body transformation picture. Now, if you have a solid physical transformation or you're making progress, by all means, use your own picture. This is not a self-absorbed post. This is something where you're showing positive results and you're offering a solution for people to get the same, okay?
You also want to include other people's transformations because you want to appear and brand yourself as a cleanse coach or a health coach, that you are coaching this person and other people on your team.
Absolutely.
To a new way. So don't just post yourself.
Yeah. So, we don't necessarily have a huge physical transformation with the products that we use because we're kind of already coming into it a little bit fit. But the point is, you can use other people's transformation pictures as well, and portray or communicate the same message that.
Yes, male and female, and children,
yes.
And old people. Yes.
Yes. So everybody, and you have to convey the idea that the picture that they're seeing is connected to what you have, and they can get the same. Okay, so it's not just post that picture and say, "Hey, awesome transformation."
Good point.
Let's clarify to your audience that what you're showing them is something attainable for them as well, because you have the vehicle. Okay, you don't want to use your company name on that post. You just want to say something like, "Isn't it amazing how powerful superfood nutrition is, or the nutritional cleansing system that I use, this person got amazing results just the same." Something simple like that, tying it together and letting them know they could have the same result. So, health quote, wealth quote, body transformation picture tied to your products, a lifestyle picture. So that would be something like, "Hey, I just made it to the top of the mountain because I'm feeling better than I ever have. I'm hiking." I got a nice organic dinner and this is my new eating habit. Or I'm at the gym and I'm going to hit some legs and we're going to tear it up because this pre-workout's got me amped up. So, you know, something like that. And then the last one is going to be in your product page, is teaching people about the products. Okay. Now, this is to get you moving, right? We actually have specific other things about teaching people about the products, but this is a minimum. When you don't know what to do, this is where to start. Okay, this doesn't stop all of your other Facebook posting about, you know, the cartoons you like to put up and the videos and stuff like that, but these are for your business. You're going to do this every day.
And I want to encourage you to not just post morning, mid-morning, and afternoon or evening. We have a lot of shift workers that work the, you know, between 2 a.m. and 6 a.m. Use buffer and post, you know, in the early morning hours as well. There's people on Facebook at that time. It's super slow when you're doing a shift work.
24/7 store, guys.
Yeah, so I mean, take advantage of those people as well, right?
Your personal page is now a 24/7 branding advertisement, basically, of a healthy, forward-thinking, success-driven, wealth-minded, positive person that wants to help other people.
So Angela820, just go to buffer.com. Remember, leaders go first. It's a great automated way to help schedule posting so you're not on Facebook all day, especially if you have a full-time job or you have 5 children and you're just super, super busy. You can't be on Facebook all day long. This is a great way to help post.
Yeah.
Posting, brand yourself as a leader and also as a cleansing coach or whatever company that you represent. Maybe you're a makeup artist of some sort.
And I've never seen a way to not show that you're using those pre-planning app situations, like when you post it, it'll show it's from Buffer, and most people it doesn't matter. As long as you're getting a good message out, it's going to connect with somebody.
Yeah, I use Buffer, and the great thing about Buffer, Hootsuite, and I'm not sure about Post Planner, but I do definitely know that Hootsuite and Buffer are connected to the Facebook algorithm, and that's why that works, because when you use Buffer and Hootsuite, more people will see it because it stays in the news feed longer.
Yes.
That's a Facebook algorithm tip. So use Buffer.
Yes.
I mean, like, intentionally use it. Don't just use it because you're busy, but intentionally use it. Okay, let's go really quickly over the rule of 5, because this is something that you've got to be doing every single day during the 90-day game plan.
We should probably finish.
Oh, I'm sorry. I jumped.
Yeah, we're going to move a little bit quicker now because I know we're going long here, but next one in the 2-week turnaround is daily goal writing. Okay, when we talk about daily goal writing, we literally mean write down the same goals every day until you achieve it, and then put a new one in its spot.
So,
for the sake of example here, we're talking about the business. We break down our goals for the business in 4 different categories. So, like Lynette was going to show you?
Yeah, so school is now in session. You can get these cool, handy-dandy, cheap marble notebooks. I have about 20 of these. This just keeps me organized because I have OCD. I got to have all the same color. But anyway, just get a marble notebook and you're going to literally write daily goals. That's the key word, daily. You're going to get a hand cramp. It's unsexy. It's monotonous.
It's not fun.
But it's not fun. But you're going to write your goals down every single day, and it's going to be the same goal. But I want you to get into the habit of writing your goals down, because why? Everything that Paul and I teach you with the two-week turnaround keeps you off the crazy train. It keeps the focus off of yourself and onto other people, or onto other positive things going and are happening in your life. So daily goal writing is not an option. It is a requirement.
Yeah. So four ways you can write down your goals. Number one, your team goal. Okay, where do you want your team to be in as far as rank advancing and moving forward in the business? Number two, your own rank goal. How what rank do you want to hit next, and by when? Okay. Number three, a money goal. You know, we get paid, like she said, daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly, but the majority of our pay is on a weekly basis. So we write down a weekly goal. And we set that intention out there of this is how much we want and this is by when. Okay, now we write it in the present positive, kind of a format. You can look up just basic goal writing. It's all the same, but there's the outlines out there. And then the last one is the prestige goal. Now the prestige goal is something that would be far out there. That's like something you got to reach for, like, I want to create 1,000 millionaires in my company, or I want to be in an industry magazine featured article, or, you know, it could be on stage training people, or it could be, I mean, whatever it is for you, something bigger, something much more significant than just your kind of, no basic goals.
So one example is last year, Paul and I wanted, one of our prestige goals was to be featured in one of our company's Stars magazine, and we did it. We're in the Stars magazine. So this would be a prestige goal, something so far-fetched, something you can't even possibly imagine, but we want you to get into the habit of writing that particular goal down. Yeah. I also have a Halloween goal, so I actually write down Halloween, October 31st, I want to achieve this. So I break it down.
Yeah, so it's just whatever it is to you, it doesn't matter. I mean, these are just all personal goals for yourself. And then, of course, you can have, you know, family goals and relationship goals and things like that. But the four that we break down for our business are those. So the team goal, your personal rank goal, your money goal, and then your prestige goal. Okay? Now, on to other things, the affirmations in the two-week turnaround. The affirmations are important because it starts to shift your mind and condition you in a way to think about positive, forward-thinking things.
But the great thing about Paul and I, we don't just teach you to write down affirmations.
Oh, yeah, this is...
But this is key with Paul and I. We teach you how to do this with emotions. It's the same thing when you're doing a vision board. Some of you will have many vision boards, but nothing is coming to fruition, and that's because you don't take the time to pause for a moment, really visualize. Visualization is so powerful, but you're using emotions or feelings, like you are really feeling you sitting inside that Corvette. You're feeling, you know, you're using your senses now. The imagination is so, so powerful. Like, imagine yourself, smell the leather, put your hands and grip the leather steering wheel. You know, like, imagine you're closing the door, how that sounds. That is what makes everything come alive and so much more vivid. You know, with my affirmations, I have literally index cards, 20, 30 index cards, and I have them in my gym bag. I have them in the truck, in the glove box. So when Paul's at a red light, I'll read these affirmations out loud for both of us, and we'll just pause for a moment and really have feelings in our affirmations. And we do this daily. Like, one of my favorite affirmations is, every day in every way my life gets better and better. Every day in every way my life gets better and better. And I just give thanks for everything that I'm going to receive. I literally say, I am. Like, for instance, if your next goal here in the next 90 days is to become a director, you actually say in the present tense, like Paul says, I am a director. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I am an executive. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Or I am a brand new manager. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So these are amazing affirmations that you should be doing every day. And I love using just handy dandy index cards. Okay.
So with that in mind, that's the two-week turnaround. We're adding value. We're reading consistently on a daily basis. Now, we teach the power reading, but you, if you just want to read one page a day and that's where you're going to start, then stay consistent with it. Branding yourself. You have to brand yourself for your business a minimum of 5 times a day, guys. That's the bottom line right there. And then daily goal writing, write down your goals until you achieve them, and then put a new one in that goal, in that place. And we gave you that 4-goal breakdown, the rank goal, the team goal, the money goal, and then the prestige goal. And then lastly, affirmations with emotions. That, again, if you look at this, the adding value, the reading, daily goals, and affirmations, 4 out of the 5 are designed to not only take the eyes off of yourself, but put the eyes on something more positive. Like she said, you know, putting your eyes on your goal, putting your eyes on other people, their needs, and how you can benefit, how you can help other people, and not only that, but yes, how you can focus on what you're trying to get.
Goal writing is however you want it. You want short-term goals and long-term goals. The prestige goal is actually a long-term goal.
Yeah, we just gave you a kind of a 4-category business goal breakdown. You can do it any way that you want. Like, you know, it doesn't even matter what goals you write down.
Well, you can have a health goal. You can have a financial goal. You can have a relationship goal. But just write your daily goals.
Yeah, so that's it. And you might get a hand cramp, and that's okay. But on to the rule of 5. Now, you're going to see how a lot of these mesh together, but you can't do one without the other. You got to have them both, because you got to shift your mind. You got to get in action before you can get in more action. So.
But this is what will shift your business, and this is what most people don't understand about the power of Facebook or the power of social media. If you are just getting on Facebook and you're just kind of throwing mud up against the wall and trying to wing it, guys, you're not going to accidentally make 6 and 7 figures in the business. But with the rule of 5, this is, you want to tell them the quick story about John Maxwell and the 5 swipes?
So John Maxwell and Jack Canfield, in fact, Jack Canfield has in his Success Principles book as well. But the story behind that is, or the idea behind it is, if you have a big tree in the backyard and you take 5 swipes with an axe at that tree trunk every day, just 5, you don't have to chop down the tree today, but if you take 5 swipes of that trunk every single day, eventually that tree will fall. And the tree falling, of course, is equivalent to you getting your goal. But the idea is to take those 5 swipes every day, not missing a day. You know, don't just because it's the holiday weekend, you take 3 days off and you're like, oh, I'll take 15 swipes on Tuesday. No. You got to take 5 every day. In fact, you know, we're trying to 10x everything. So Lynette and I are trying to take more than 5 swipes a day. We're trying to repeat this over and over and over as much as we can. But the point is that you stay consistent. If all you can do is all you can do, then do all that you can do. And if that means the 5 swipes a day, then do that. Okay, so with the 5 swipes a day in your business, we broke it down, and this is where that comes from.
You must be a product of the product. And I know that sounds like a no-brainer, but you'll be surprised how many people on your team are not even product of the product. If you're a product of the product, that means you're using the products on a daily basis. And Paul and I like to say you can either be a good, better, or best in terms of using the product. When you first start out, you may just want to start out with some shakes and maybe Ionic Supreme or whatever company that you represent. But then you want to work your way up to better. Maybe add Ionic Supreme, shakes, and Cleanse for Life. But then now, Paul and I are at the best of using the product of the product daily. I'm on the vitamins. I'm on the sleep spray. I'm on the ageless joint support. I'm on, Isa Immune. I'm on everything. So I'm using everything. And if you are a true product of the product and you represent your company in the most correct way, then you should never, ever go inactive. That is non-negotiable. When Paul lost his job and I quit medical school and had no student loans coming in, we had no money. I mean, when we're broke, we're broke. And we still kept our business active. Mm-hmm. I can't stress that enough. If nothing changes, then nothing changes. There should be non-negotiable. Talk to your spouse and just say, we're keeping this business open. I'd rather keep the business open and active than pay our cell phone bill. Because again, Paul and I didn't have a cell phone bill. We didn't have internet. We got things shut off. We were taking showers in the community center during the initial stages of our business because we made it a point to keep our business active without fail. That was non-negotiable. Product of the product. That is the rule of 5, number 1. Number two, you can, this is called prospecting, and you can implement the four Fs. You're prospecting not only out and about, outside of Facebook, but you're also prospecting on Facebook, utilizing branding. You're branding yourself. The four Fs, if you're not familiar with the four Fs, we'll go over that on another day. But you also want to be following up.
The big FU. Guys, most
FU, yeah, right?
Most professionals don't do that. Professional networkers are the only ones that that are following up. Most other non-professionals, I'm sorry, let me clarify, non-professionals are not following up. And that's what really separates people.
This is where everybody is messing up right here, is the following up. And I don't want this word to scare you. Many of you are misunderstanding what following up means. You think that following up means calling someone on the phone and ask them if they're, or they're ready to jump on board with you. Following up is so much more than just that.
And it's so much easier than what you think.
So let me just talk about this real quick, because I think these are going to tie and this is all going to make sense for you. When we're talking about the rule of five, you are a product of the product. You're prospecting both outside Facebook and inside Facebook. You're following up. But I want you to look at these three, because this is actually, they're actually combined.
They're tied together.
They're tied together. You're teaching about the products in your product group page, but you're also teaching about the business in the business page. You're following up. You're teaching about the products in the product page, and you're teaching about the business in the business page. But following up is teaching. Following up is teaching. Teaching is educating, and that's all that we're doing. We educate, they decide, and then we support.
Sound familiar?
But this is where everybody drops the ball, because you'll put people or you'll add people into your product page, and then you take off. Nobody knows where you're at. When you post, you educate, and you're supposed to be teaching about the product. So if I make a video or I post about my amazing Ageless Essentials with product B and Isogenesis, well, then I'm teaching about the product, but I'm also following up. This is also following up. If I welcome someone into my product page and I add a tool, that is also considered a follow-up. All of these things are layering. They're all intertwined. Can I call someone up and do a three-way call and follow up that way? Absolutely. Can I call someone or text them or private message them? Yes, I can do that too. That's also considered follow-up. But where 99% of your follow-up will take place is actually in the product page. Because as I'm educating and as I'm posting, again, I'm not sharing. Please do not use the share button. Leaders do not share and leaders do not tag. Please do not use the, don't tag your prospects. But when you post and you're educating and you're encouraging and you're inspiring and your prospects see that you're encouraging and you're inspiring, you actually look and brand yourself as an amazing leader. And that's what we all strive for. We're all striving to become inspirational leaders. So this is really important that you understand this.
Guys, real quick, just a little clarification on that tagging thing, because I know some people are like, wait, I can't tag people. Guys, there are times to tag and times not to tag. But if you're using tagging because of your to compensate for your lack of posting, then you're doing it wrong.
It's lazy leadership, okay, when you're tagging. So for instance, if I make a video or I post about Ageless Essentials, I'm strategizing the way that I'm posting, because I'm actually posting for my prospects and I'm posting for my team members' prospects. There's a reason why I'm posting, right? But if you tag your prospect into my post, consider that lazy leadership, because you should be teaching about this product also. Because that's how we change the Facebook algorithm. When you post, your prospects get a notification on their phone that, oh my gosh, Lynette just posted in the product page. Let me go check that out. And she's going to start scrolling. I'm bringing her back into the product page. Does that make sense? Each time you post, your prospect gets a notification on their phone and on their computer. That brings them back into the product page. You are now educating and inspiring and teaching about your products. That is called and considered a follow-up, right? You can also implement that with other different ways, doing your own old school traditional ways too. That includes follow-up too, but I just really, really want to emphasize that this is how you shift your business. You're posting and you're teaching and you're encouraging in the comments section. Let your prospects see that you're encouraging, because we get paid to be professional encouragers. We get paid to be a professional cheerleader. Mm-hmm. So don't forget that most important aspect of this.
So why do we have the 2-week turnaround first and the rule 5-second? Because we have to generate curiosity with the branding and the 2-week turnaround. We have to kind of get ourselves off the crazy train, learn how to add value in people's lives in order for prospecting to work. Then once we can prospect efficiently, we add them to the product page, and then after that we're following up, and then after that we're teaching about the products, and then eventually teaching about the business. Do you see how that all fits together?
Okay.
Again, it's very seamless. They'll go back and forth, but you're doing it all.
I want to emphasize this, because what's holding many of you back is because you've been socially programmed to think that people are getting overwhelmed or annoyed. People know how to work Facebook, I promise you. People know how to turn off notifications, I promise you. But here's where you're going to plant a seed. Is when you introduce somebody or welcome someone into a product page, it is your responsibility, you. If you add someone into the product page, it is your responsibility to let your prospect know that this is an overwhelming, fast-paced, high-energy page. But if you'll just, you know, take a look around, look at the photos and files, view the beautiful, amazing transformations that are in this page, you're going to be mind blown. You are going to love it. Let me repeat that. You are going to love it. I'm planting a seed. I'm letting them know that it's high fat. It's high energy, fast paced. It may seem overwhelming, but let them know they can turn off the notifications. That's okay if you want to. I don't do that because I don't want to plant a seed. I want them to love it. So if you set your prospect up for success and let them know that the group is fast-paced, but there's so many beautiful transformations, so many beautiful, inspiring stories, you're going to love it. I'm planting a seed. That's why Paul and I never, ever get a prospect saying, oh my God, this is so overwhelming, they take themselves out. I don't do that because I'm planting a seed that they're going to love it. And with my own content, with my own posting, they get inspired by it. They get inspired by it. So trust me, if you drop your prospect off in the product page and you don't tell them that it's fast paced and you don't post, trust me, they're going to leave. They're going to find it annoying. They're going to find it annoying because you initially set them up that this is going to be a life changing gift. And then you just kind of dropped off and they don't know where you're at.
I'm like, what happened?
What happened to you? Of course they're going to get annoyed.
They only look to you for the connection to the whole new world that you've just exposed them to.
Yeah.
So you can't disappear. Guys, we've said this 1,000 times before, but you have to look at your product group page as your virtual store. If you're going to bring a customer into the store, if you're going to escort them right into your store, if it was a physical store, you wouldn't just say, okay, I got to go. I mean, that doesn't even make sense. If you own that physical store and you escorted your prospect right in the store, you're going to show them around. You're going to show them what the products you have. You're going to help them understand what this can do for them. And the way we do that in a virtual world is by posting.
We don't have new topics. We don't have new topics. We sound like a broken record, and I know that we sound like a broken record to some of you who just posted, who just commented, but this is it. This is how we built a multiple six-figure business. We do the 2-week turnaround. We do the rule of five. We talk about anticipating objections. We go into the 14-day talk. We go into core wounds. We go through A through Z. This is the notches on the key. We talk about the same thing. After 72 episodes, we talk about the same thing because this is what we do for our business. This is what has shifted our business, and this is what has shifted those that do it.
Let me just make something clear about that, okay? If you think that there are some other secret techniques out there that are going to change your business, then you need to understand that that's not the case. The bottom line is the boring, unsexy, monotonous basics over and over and over and over and over. Are you tired of hearing that? Over and over. Guys, there's nothing else. Just do it over and over again. And then if you didn't get it, then for us to say it 10 times over in the last 72 days, maybe now's the time. Maybe now is the time that, oh, it clicks now, okay?
Yeah.
Guys, there's nothing to it. If you talk to us a year from now, guess what'll happen?
We're still doing the same thing.
We're gonna tell you about the 2-week turnaround rule of five. Guys, there's nothing to this. It's just do the same thing. How did Jill get to be a 13-star platinum? she's done the same basics over and over and over and over again, much more than we have, and that's why she's where she is.
Yeah. So somebody asked really quickly, and then we'll jump off because we know it's a beautiful Tuesday. You have other things to do than listen to us on Periscope. But somebody wanted to know, can we go over belly to belly? And we do. We go over the four F's. So when Paul and I are out and about, and we know when we need to leave the house. It's just something we've got to do. We can't...
Hate leaving the house.
We can't... I could literally stay behind my phone all day. But we know that we need to meet other people out and about and share this gift. And how do we do it belly to belly? It's the same thing. We compliment and ask a question. And literally 9 times out of 10, it never leads to the business. We compliment and ask a question, and 9 times out of 10, it never leads to the business, but many times it does, and that's when it's a beautiful thing. So when I meet someone out and about, I'm getting a conversation, I'm complimenting, I'm asking them a question, how long have you worked here? Oh my God, that's a beautiful necklace, where did you get that? Oh, that's a, you know, oh, your kids are so cute, oh my God, how old are they? We're just chit-chatting, just talking, and if the opportunity presents itself, I will do the four F's. Oh my God, you know what? You waited tables so amazing. You have great customer service skills. I can see you doing what I do. Well, what do? Well, you know what? I help people feel better. I get them financially free and I get them fit. You know, we're holistic health coaches. I said, why don't I show you exactly what we do? Are you on Facebook? And she'll go, yeah, I'm on Facebook. Well, here, go ahead and just find you on Facebook. I'll friend you right now. She'll find herself. I give her my phone because this is building trust. I hand her my phone. She finds herself, right? Friend request you right there. And then I'll go home and send her a beautiful message. A private message on Facebook changes the Facebook algorithm because now I want her in my newsfeed and I want to see her in my newsfeed in case there's something that I can connect with. Mm-hmm. A private message and say, oh my God, it was great connecting with you today at Whole Foods. I want to go ahead and add you to my support page so you can kind of see exactly what I do. Don't worry, the group is a little bit fast paced, but it's so much fun. You're going to love it. And she'll go, okay. And so I add her and welcome her in, and then there it goes. It's a beautiful transition. Once I welcome her in, she feels like she's part of a community, she's part of a family, and then my entire team will start welcoming her in and feeling, you know, and they'll add a video, they'll add why Isogenics, or they'll add Isogenics difference in the bottom, and it's just a beautiful camaraderie, and all of a sudden she feels like she's part of a team and part of a amazing family. And then I'll follow up with her 12 hours later or 24 hours later, and then add a second layer. I'll add a getting started video in the bottom of the welcome platform. And then there we go. So that's how it starts. But when you're belly to belly, it's literally starting off with complimenting and asking a question and trying to wiggle my way to see if I can do the four F's. Most of the time, it doesn't lead to that. Yesterday, Paul and I went to the movies. The movie theater was freezing, so I wanted to get a little jacket before I went into the movie theater. And the gentleman that was helping me grab the jacket from the top shelf was a great college kid, great personality. Paul tried to do the four F's with him. Hey man, you know, you're great at this. How long have you been doing this? And he went into why he was in college, what he's studying in college, psychology, and how he wants to go to medical school, and small talk. But that particular moment didn't open up to do the four F's. It just didn't, so we didn't force it. But we are always trying to do the four F's when we're belly to belly with someone, mm-hmm. Okay?
Yeah, it's funny because the store phone at the store they were at, he was kind of ringing us up, and the store phone rang, and I was like, we gotta go catch the movie. So, you know, it's like, it's whatever. Like, so what? There's a billion other people on the planet that want this. So, you know, that's cool. Or maybe one day I'll go back and we'll see him. So...
Yeah. And don't forget, if I have a friend on Facebook and she's been watching me but she's not in the business, I compliment and ask a question via private Facebook. And I'll ask her, are you ready? You know, she's been watching me. She likes and she comments. And I just say, you know, are you ready? I can see you doing this. You'd be amazing at what we do. You know, I'm complimenting. I want to encourage her to join my team. Are you ready yet? Are you ready yet? So many different ways that you can do this, but I want to leave you with this. You know, our methods work, and your methods can work too. You can implement old school stuff with our new stuff, but if you want to have a fast business and you want to have a more effective business and really reach your team and prospects in a whole brand new way, start strategizing the way that you're on Facebook. Don't waste your time on Facebook anymore. I know we went a little bit long today, but I think it's important because we're in the middle of a 90-day game plan and some of you are still struggling. But it's important. Please do the 2-week turnaround. Do the rule of five. Even if you did it half-assed, you'd still get amazing results. But I want to emphasize this. Adding value to people's lives is the most important rule. If you take anything out of this episode, add value to people's lives. Posting using Buffer and Hootsuite is amazing, but if you're not encouraging your team, and if you're not telling someone, I believe in you, great job, keep going, you're doing an amazing, you know, whatever it is, but add value, compliment people, and make people feel like they're part of a special team. And don't be lazy in your language, because when we communicate more effectively, you'll see how you can begin adding value to people's lives. So, with that said, you want to add anything else so we can wrap this up?
Oh, no, you said it all much better than I could.
I can't believe we talked this long. So sorry. But I thought a lot of this was really important.
We had to get this out because we knew there's a lot of new people. So thank you for hanging on with us. And we're going to go ahead and break some stuff down over the next week or so.
Four F's can be awkward, but after, seriously, 72, I want to really analogy. Well,
Go ahead.
Because when Paul and I started Periscope, it was the most awkward. We were retarded. Oh my God, we couldn't get it right. We were trying to figure out how this thing worked. But after 72 episodes, after doing something 72 times, you will become an expert at it. You will become much more comfortable with it. So even if you do the four F's and it sounds awkward and kind of wonky in the beginning, try it for 72 times. It'll actually be much more effective.
Let me just clear something up. It sounds awkward to you, but the person you're talking to, they have no idea what you're saying. They just want to know, okay, well, what do you do? It is only in your mind that you think it's awkward. It's only in your mind that you think that you're sounding weird, okay? The person that you're talking to doesn't know what's behind those thoughts. All they know is that you're talking to them and you're saying words to them. And if you ask them a question, they will answer it, okay? So I help people feel better, get fabulously fit, financially free. Are you on Facebook? They didn't even care about the other three
F's. They probably didn't even hear you.
They just heard, are you on Facebook? Yeah. Okay, well, I'd be more than happy to show you what I do. And then you connect with them and you're done. Guys, again, this is all about crazy train management. Get off the crazy train. Stop thinking about what you think you sound like. Nobody else knows what you think that you're thinking. All they know is what is coming out of your mouth at that moment. And all they hear is, are you on Facebook? Something about fit and free. Cool, let's do this. I'm ready to go. Like, well, show me more. And then you support them by educating them. And then they'll make their decision. So that's it. So anyway.
Good. I like that.
Don't think too much about it.
Get off the crazy train. Manage it today.
The fact that you think it's awkward, it's only illusion in your mind. It's not really a big deal, guys.
Okay, cool. We're wrapping this up. We're going to go to the gym. Today is back day. So we always do Periscope, and then we go to the gym. Do you see how consistent and boring we are? Nothing we do is really...
Boring? This is fun. Back attack.
Anyway, as always, we want nothing more than for you to live the most extraordinary life.
Always free from both physical and financial pain.
So join us on this mission.
Because this is Stone Cold Fact.
We got a better way. Now let's go tell the world. Go get that 50 book. Isn't that crazy? 50 cent. Hello.
Yeah,
I don't know how to turn this off.
Yeah, that's